Hello, we are Theodor Sigaev and Alexander Kratkov from Postgres Professional, and today we are going to talk about smart JSONB indexing, parameterized up classes. This talk was intended to be given by Nikita Glukhov and Oleg Bortunov, but unfortunately nobody from these two is coming. This is why we and Theodor will talk about that. Okay, so a little bit of introduction. What is indexes? Indexes is some structure which used for search, and eventually this structure contains pointers to tuple, to heap pages or tuples. In Postgres implementation, index has no information about visibility. So if you find some tuple from index, it's only candidate. That also should be rechecked for visibility. Yes, indexes are used only for acceleration of search. So in principle, you should always be able to perform the same search with same results without indexes. Indexes could be partial to be applied to only some tuples from the table according to some predicate. Functional, so not column is to be indexed, but result of some function, and multi-column when multiple columns participate in index, and it depends on particular index time of how that works. Indexes are not always useful because they have maintenance overhead and can be slow when selectivity is low. So this is our list of indexes, starting from B3 hash, then our work from Theodor Sigaev, Oleg Bortunov, and some kinds of me, GIST, GNSP, GIST, yes, and Bloom, yes, and Room, and Vodka, which is in progress. Brin index, which is indexes ranges of blocks, and we also listed OUSA by Markus Nullmeier, but unfortunately that was never published yet. Okay. And also we need to introduce a conception of operator class, because it's kind of not so evident conception, and not every Postgres users even knows what op class is. So op class is so-called operator class, which is actually glue between index access methods and particular data type. So for instance, in order to build a B3 over some data type, you need a comparison function which tells Postgres how should you compare values of this type, and there could be many comparison functions for some data type. For instance, you can compare strings from beginning to end, but you can compare string in the reverse order from last character to first, and that's also a way to compare string. Yes, and you can define another op class which should work with this comparison function. So it's about B3, but later we would talk about operator classes for other index types.
You see, it's plain that an operator class, usually you use default one, but you can specify specific if you need it. And in this example, text pattern ops, it's a special kind to speed up like operator, like text operator like, and there is a problem with support with default classes, class with different encoding, collation actually, but text pattern ops doesn't pay attention to collation at all. So it's allowed to use for like.
Yes, so text pattern ops compares just byte per byte. And what is the problem with current indexing infrastructure is that up classes doesn't define their own parameters, and sometimes it's a problem because at first up classes have hard-coded constants. For instance, it's signature size when it's a signature tree implemented on top of GIST and other constants also.
Actually, it was the first our contribution to PostgreSQL with Oleg. It was an interray contrib extension model. And it contains some signature. Signature is defined, length of signature is defined in compile time. Of course, it's not fits all purposes, fits all collections. So just now, just hard coded, but we want to have it configurable at create index command.
Yes. Another reason to define op class specified parameter is is indexing non-atomic data types like arrays, JSONB, ETS vector, and so on. And by parameters, you can specify what parts of this data container you actually going to index. And another reason is use different algorithms for indexing. For example, when GIST implements R3, then you could choose between a split algorithm, which could give you trade-off between scan speed and index build time, and so on. Yeah, so on this slide, you can see proposed syntax for up class parameters. So idea is that when you specify some column which you index, you also can specify op class, and then you have braces, and inside a pair key value equal to a value. And there is example when we index in array. Then we specify for GIST in big ops, which internally is signature tree, you can specify length of signature. And for default op class, which approximates array as some conjunction ranges, you can specify maximum number of ranges that index K can hold. Yes. About internal implementation, all the parameters are serialized as text array in pgindex. So pgindex have entries about information about all indexed columns. So this text array contains per column parameters, and for single column, all the parameters are serialized in single text. Yes, so this is an example of how that this could like. This the second string is an example which was on previous slide, but just serialize it in the table. The first line is example for JSONB when we select which passes of JSONB we are going to index, and for specification SQL JSON is used, which we will talk a little bit later. So in order to support op class specified parameters, we have to extend interface to index access method. We have a new function which enumerates the parameters available for particular index access method. Index access method can just delegate the procedure of selecting available parameter to op class, because you know in access methods like gene or gist, op classes have a lot of freedom in selecting what they are going to do. Yes, and it's natural to just delegate to them to define parameters these subclasses needs.
Actually, it's very similar to IAM specific options, it's close to the same idea, except that it's per operator class, per column use storage and so on. Next one, please. For example, contrib interarray model already mentioned here. We add new function, alter operator family, so it's okay. We use possibility in Postgres to upgrade, to add new, to modify operator classes. In fact, we use here that PostgreSQL stores any information in system catalog, and we store that in system catalog and uses the original idea to use non-traditional base type. Okay, let we look at an example. Gist, in short, gist it's who know what is the R3? 1, 2, 3. Okay. Gist is just generalization of R3 to any data type who has a concept about
union,
so common union for whole subtree. And this union K could
hold all the keys inside this subtree.
Yeah. Okay. So GIST itself provides navigation on tree, search, insert, provides support consistency, concurrency, recovery. So programmer don't need to bother about that. Example. It's a R3 example with Gris. You know, you see the bounding boxes here, and on the second and more level, it's very close already to the actual map.
Yes, and another example of GIST is RD3. So RD3, it comes from Russian doll tree. You know, the Russian doll is a doll where one doll contains a similar doll of smaller size and so on many times. And RD3 makes an index structure for sets, and the idea that in every non-leaf K you contain set which bounding for, you know, all the keys in the subtree, and when you want to search this tree, then you don't visit the tree branches which you can see that for sure doesn't contain matching rows. For instance, we are querying for array which contains both 2 and 9. Right branches doesn't contain 2. We don't visit it. and we visit left branch. Here we see that left branch doesn't contain two again. Yes, and we visit right branch, and so on. We find the leaf tuple matching our query. Yes, this is Tom Lane with a Russian doll. We gifted to him, and he looks very interesting. Yes, and about application of RD3 for full-text search, you know that the size of all possible number of all possible words is large to enumerate all of them in single index k. This is why we need some kind of compact representation, and one of ideas of this common representation is so-called signature. Idea signature that is that we get lexem, calculate hash from that, and according to this sets bits in signature. Depending on algorithm, it could be single bit, two bits, and so on. There are some trade-offs. Yes, so there is an example where we set two bits for every word. You know, there is a table. Yes, and if we are searching for a certain word, then we are going to, we are traversing our tree, and we are going to the branches where all the bits of the word we are searching for are set. So we visit left branch and so on and find the matching rows.
Union key in signature tree is actually bitwise or all keys in subtree.
Yes, that's it.
Again, yeah. Int array, null free one-dimensional array, and for example, support intersect operator. And it suggested two operator classes. The default, historically it was first, and now it's still default. It's rather, it's not very easy to change default of classes. And so it has a limitation, just a comment here, that if you don't know what you do, please do not use it. It's its performance very depend on size of your collection. Next one, another signature tree. It's there is in core, in the index for full text search of TS vector use int array, L tree model. It's a label tree actually. PG trigame trigram to find similar words. And all of them uses use the signature, so they use hard-coded length of signature. So for GIST, we suggest this feature to define on SQL level the signature length. Let me try to make an example. Simple generation and three indexes differ in signature length. Default is 252, I don't remember, bytes or integers?
Bits? No.
No, bytes.
Okay.
It's merged in bytes, okay. Subject to change, you see, I will try to show creation time of indexes. Okay, then you have less signature length, then you have a faster creation time and less index size. And simple test for timing, you see, we have a win because index be. Our index becomes smaller, but actually you should understand. You should understand that is for just a specific test. If your set is very different from that, you may do not get that result. You will get.
Yeah. So idea that signature length with shorter signature, you would get more false positives, but you get smaller index. With larger signature, you get less false positive. But yes. But index is larger, so it's trade-off, and it's reasonable to give user ability to choose this trade-off.
Jin, you know, very short introduction. Jin looks like index in scientific or maybe.
Or not so scientific book.
Yes. There is a list of terms in the end of book to make a fast search. It's exactly inverted index. Generalize it, okay? It's not only about words, but in other types too. And so the search inside Jin looks like we want to find accelerometer compensation, for example, and the need to intersect to list to find the page on which there is both terms. Now Jin is basically just a B-tree with some optimization to store a lot of duplicate keys. It's use compression, and unlike all other indexes, it could store pointers to multiple pointers to one tuple in the heap.
So it extracts from a single heap tuple, it extracts multiple index entries to which it inserts into index.
Full text search example, it's just separated terms from the text. And it, at least now, doesn't support interface get to get one by one tuples, just the bitmap scan only. Very similar function to parse and store options of for operator class. Very similar. And
yes, and we need to explain about Jin operator classes because they would participate in further examples. When we index JSONB using Jin, there are two operator classes which are shown in this slide by example. JSONB ops extracts keys in values separately, so you just get a list of all keys and values which are present in your JSONB document. And the problem here is that posting lists and trees would be very large because you are likely going to have very many duplicates at least for keys. And it might be slow, but the advantage of this index is that you can search for presence of particular key very easy. JSONB PathOps is different top class. It extracts all the passes from this this JSONB document, so paths which ends with some value in this JSONB document, and for shortness it calculates hash out of that. And this index is good for lookup for particular paths in JSONB. For instance, it's accelerate JSONB contains JSONB, very good, but it can search for separate keys present in JSONB.
Actually, our patch does not implement that, but it's actually possible to show to operator class to please, could you make some mix of these two operator classes? For example, for K1, please, please index the hash. For K2, please index keys separate and value separate. It could be mixed. It's not implemented now, but it's possible to do that, to try to in try to replace these two operator classes with one. So just where it could be useful. For example, we don't want to index the whole T vector, just part, for example, title. So we need to add a filter to remove all words except
For T vector, it's also possible to do something even more smarter. For instance, you want to search by titles to be very fast. And right now, how T vector index works, it's just search ignoring ways and then filters when title is matching. But what we can do with class parameters, we can specify that we want to index title separately, so label ways A separately and B, C, D separately. And so when we're searching for title, we are doing this quite fast because we index this separately. But if we go into search anywhere, we have to union from these two. So there is a set of interesting options for full text search users.
For JSON, the idea initially was it's some subset of to project JSON in column to something another JSON to be indexed. And it could be different from just filter, maybe some restructure of that JSON. Sorry again, but our lecture contains a lot of introductions. Again, there is the standard SQL JSON, and we have a patch which implements that standard. In PostgreSQL, it's very it was very pity that it's not.
Not implemented yet.
No, it's not. It's not in the 11th version, but I hope it will be in 12. It suggests a lot of features. One of it is JSON path is some way to operate with the hierarchy of JSON in a relation database. For example, this looks assembly-like code allows, it's by standard, it's not our fantasy, allows to pass parameter to the query. You see passing 40 as min, 90 as max, and with these variables with dollar sign is used to filter actually some subset of JSON B. Maybe kind
of. Maybe standard authors was inspired by Perl. Why not?
Actually, the author of that standard is Microsoft and Oracle. Why they so like Perl, I don't know. Okay, it's some description of our office in Moscow, and this transformation allows to take all.
It finds on it returns you on floors 0 and 1 apartments. Starting from 1, something like this.
Yes, some kind of filter. Another possibility to make from JSON some kind of relational table to use for in query. Okay, I'm sorry, it should be separate lecture about possibility of that, so very short. And we suggest to add just a projection now in this patch to get a subset of JSON to index. Again, pair like structures. Sorry.
Okay, so we have projection parameter, which is basically extracts from this JSONB document passes which we are going to index. Star here is possibly any array element, right? And so standard also have something like lux and strict mod, you know, and these two probably something like equivalent, I believe. And second is more simple example of how this is going to work. It's actually very similar how our regular indexes by columns work. So we index, you know, KA, and if we are searching by KB, we will get sequential scan because, you know, gene cost estimate, get list of extracted keys, realizes that gene is going to do full scan and fall back to sequential scan. This is how this that works. And in other case, then we in example, when we have OR, then we still fall back to sequential scan because we can fast find condition for A but can't get it for B. But when we have AND, then we can find of it for A equal 1 and for A equal B, we will do the recheck. So it's similar to regular index on columns. Yes, it's a common JSONB data set which is widely used in various benchmarks. And we compare multiple indexes here. So we already describe your difference between JSONB ops and JSONB path ops. And also we will check JSONB ops and JSONB path ops in the case when we index only terms of tags.
One second, please. Yes, only tags, the bold font, you see the only these subset to index.
Right. Okay. And there are also another indexes. The first is expression index, when we also extract terms of tags, but we are doing this using expression index. So this weird operator, this is operator which I believe extracts, extracts values according to JSON path. Yes, and we index it into ways using default op class, JSONB ops, and JSONB path ops. Another example is also another expression index, but it gets not using our operator, but using JSON query. I don't know. Can you describe how this is different from previous?
Different examples. You know, there is several ways how to do functional index, and we tried several ways to find to compare, and resulting we have how much 10 indexes. And differ. Okay, the first two is most universal. It could be used for any queries, but you see that 10 times more. Size of other indexes close to the same, but they are differ in creation time because you see the functional indexes is most complicated for CPU to make. When we test, you know, you have 10 indexes, very different size and structure, And usually not very like when not very comfortable to use 10 tables or 10 to drop create indexes should be very slow. There is model extension plan tuner. It has capability to just hide indexes from the planner. Okay, it's not very comfortable way too, but it's much easier in time because you don't need to drop create, you don't need a copy and so on. Please read pointed links.
Okay, and this is examples of how queries work, and now queries are for full or selective indexes. Actually, for them, performance appears to be the same because indexes are in memory. You know, all of them was in memory. This is why full indexes contains extra information which wasn't used.
I'd like to say that you see the size of indexes is 10 times different, but time to execute close to the same just because other part just stored on disk and doesn't read it at all. So you just use a lot of disk space for
index in all other keys in the document. And there is also time for expression indexes, for functional indexes. And we can see that it's pretty fast. And you can notice that when we use just array of texts, then there is it working GNOP class for texts, which use no recheck, and this is why here index scan is much faster. And in another case, which is slower than others, is when we use some expensive function, which we write probably in SQL or PGSQL, when it takes a lot of time to execute, and recheck is slower. Other times is probably similar.
What different in these queries you see, you on this slide, you just okay, it looks simpler, but on here you need to repeat the expression which was used for index creation. Big one. Usually it's not comfortable to check by to write by hand.
Yes, and so some conclusion of our testing. So at first, if we have some selective indexes, so if we index only some particular keys, then our indexes are much smaller and takes much less time to build, and that is quite evident. So selective indexes allow you to do more flexible queries. Yes, and search by functional JSONB indexes are faster than searching by full or selective ones because fewer index entries are scanned because JSONB path extracts keys separately, values separately, and it would be just have scan less of duplicates. Functional JSONB indexes, which subqueries in expression are slow because they are just, you know, slower functions which would be calculated on update, insert, or recheck. Yes, and search for text array is fastest because it doesn't contain recheck. Yes, and the roadmap for improvements. And one thing we are going to do is to support filter of indexing paths. So don't only specify the paths you are going to index, but also specify some filter on them. For instance, you are going to index only array of certain sizes and so on. Another thing is to support expression indexes, so you can index A plus B, and later you would be able to search on A plus B. Date time support, so and type support, so it basically support of calling of JSON path functions inside the projection. Okay, and also we have a good model for another good model for JSONB indexes is jsquery, and jsquery also have experimental branch with support of class parameters, and there are JS path language. And according to this, you also can specify some projection in jsquery, and in a similar way, you would get indexed only some passes in JSONB documents.
If you do that, what you have on that slide, so you have an index with a specific projection like that.
Yes. Yes.
Like the second last select down there?
Second, well, this one?
The upper one of the selects, that one.
Okay.
Now if you change that query so that it would say instead of hash.a equals one, change that to say hash.z equals one, would you still be able to use the index?
Yeah, so in this case it probably yes, because second condition you know matches index, and one first could be done by a check, but if it would be not end by or, then you wouldn't be able to use index.
Can the planner detect that?
Planner can detect that because planner calls gin cost estimate, while gin cost estimate call gin query extract from a class and gets that gin query extract say that scan all the index, calculate very large cost, and planner gets that it would be better to do sequential scan. That works.
And Nikita implements jsquery in he supposed that this patch could be accepted by committers, by contributors, but he worries about SQL JSON patch. And so jsquery is just an extension and could be used without SQL JSON patch. So just another way to do the same. Actually, when we show you on some first slides the storage of options, and personally I don't like that at all. And there is some other places. Any options, you know, actually stored as text array, but you know, to know that first element is a name of option, second is a value of option, third again it's a name of option, and so on. I suppose we need to discuss about JSONification of system catalog to move that data to the JSONB. Okay, it could be not JSONB, but special data type to store. But why we need to develop special data type if we already has a good container for that? Thank you.